Hey, I did my presentation on LGBTQ plus rights. Times are uncertain for LGBTQ plus individuals across the U.S. right now. As Clarence Thomas had made clear in his dissenting opinion after the overturning of Roe v. Wade, gay rights are in a very scary place. The current political makeup of the Supreme Court and the inaction of the House and Senate to codify queer rights into law can mean the reversal of decades of queer activism, possibly even the overturning of marriage equality. Taking into account that 5 LGBTQ plus individuals were killed at a Colorado nightclub on the 19th, the day before Trans Day of Remembrance, and we see just how dire our situation really is at the moment. This isn't even mentioning the nightmare of trying to receive gender-affirming care in the U.S. According to a Trevor Project 2022 national survey, 93% of transgender and non-binary youth have said that they have worried about being denied access to gender-affirming medical care due to state or local laws, and 36% of LGBTQ youth have been physically threatened or harmed due to sexual orientation or gender identity. Republican and right-wing politicians have demonized, harassed, and made the lives of trans youth a living hell. They politicize people who struggle with body dysmorphia and just want to live their truth. Even in states without laws prohibiting it, the complicated and tedious process to get the surgeries, their enormous cost, and the social stigmatization that ultimately comes with getting them makes the whole process unnecessarily difficult. We live in a nation where it's far easier to get a gun than it is to feel comfortable in your own body. Yet as queer history has shown us, we are nothing if not resilient. Since the first brick was thrown at Stonewall, the queer community has been endlessly fighting and supporting one another through social justice. Yet, it's important to realize that it takes the support of everyone to make a movement, and there has been no better tools for queer social change than allyship and representation. Like we've seen in the aftermath of the overturning of Roe v. Wade, participating in our elections matters a lot. We staved off a red wave, have the power to actually codify LGBTQ plus rights into law right now. According to Gallup News, support for same-sex marriage is at the highest it's ever been, at 71%, which is actually 21% higher than it was a decade ago. Now is the best time for action in social justice for LGBTQ plus rights. If that 71% of people were to vote for ballot initiatives that codified queer rights, then the Supreme Court's possible decision to overturn marriage equality would be far less detrimental. While political activism is a much-needed and powerful tool, it's not the only way to help. Promoting LGBTQ plus representation is also such an effective means of helping out. The Trevor Project states that 89% of LGBTQ youth report that seeing representation in TV shows and movies made them feel good about being LGBTQ. Showing somebody that someone like them not only exists, but can live happily is a profoundly impactful comfort. It's also an action that is easy to do. You probably already listen to music or watch movies or TV shows with LGBTQ plus representation or creators. Supporting their identity and craft lets queer people know that you support them. So just like we did this midterm, I implore you to get out and help codify LGBTQ plus rights. Let our politicians know that trans rights are human rights, that love is love, and whether the Republicans and the far right like it or not, we're here and we're queer. So, going back to this slide, I mentioned the Colorado Springs nightclub shooting that just happened, I think it's like 2 weeks ago now. It was the day right before Trans Day of Remembrance, where we remember transgender people, non-binary people who lost their lives either to suicide or to murder. And so I wanted to offer my condolences and a memoriam to the victims of the Club Q shooting. We had Daniel Ashton, who was 28, Raymond Green Vance, who was 22, Ashley Pa, who was 35, Kelly Loving, who was 40, and Derek Rump, who was 38. And I offered this quote at the bottom by Harvey Milk that reads, "All young people, regardless of sexual orientation or identity, deserve a safe and supportive environment in which to achieve their full potential." I offer this quote because are we really in a society right now that promises the safety and supportive environment that Harvey Milk wants for the LGBTQ youth? Or are all LGBTQ youth even able to achieve their full potential? My nonviolent resistance movement playlist includes a lot of different genres. I have some pop, some classic rock, some alt rock, some hip hop, indie, some classical. I wanted to make sure that whoever listens to this playlist could get some enjoyment out of it and learn either through the artist, like artists like Pyotr, Tchaikovsky, Samuel Barber, or Freddie Mercury, or Elton John. They're all gay artists. I was hoping that through listening to their music, you can kind of learn the struggle of the fight for LGBTQ rights. The song I want to focus on is Sun Goes Down by Lil Nas X. It's a very, very good song. I highly recommend the entire Montero album, but I will go ahead and play it for you right now.
Since 10, I've been feeling lonely. Have friends, but they was picking on me. I was thinking when my lips so big, was I too dark in essence, my fears? These gay thoughts would always haunt me. I pray God would take it from me. It's hard for you when you're fighting, and nobody knows it when you're silent. I'd be by the phone, standing Nicky morning into dawn. Only place I feel like I belong. Strangers make you feel so loved, you know. And I'm happy by the way that I made that jump, that leap of faith. I'm happy that it all worked out for me. So proud of me, oh.
So that song speaks to a lot of the struggles that the LGBTQ plus individuals face. A lot of it has to do with being in the closet, and also even out of the closet. Lil Nas X is speaking about the struggles that he faced when coming out in 2019 as an artist, and it's a very hard time out there for LGBTQ plus people right now. Suicide rates are like very high for the LGBTQ community in areas where they're not accepted. But research has shown that if their community is accepting that people reach out and confirm their gender identity and sexuality, that it greatly improves their, or it greatly diminishes risks of suicide. That's my presentation. Thank you. Hey, Dane, what was your anti-paper about? Thank you, Dane. My anti-paper was about kind of three key things. I focused on religious liberty and whether or not codifying LGBTQ plus rights, specifically marriage equality, is going against religious liberty. Because in our First Amendment, we have obviously religion or freedom of religion, which certain religions do not support same-sex marriage. So is legalizing same-sex marriage going against religious liberty? The second point was kind of the benefits of a traditional family unit, kind of the idea of like man and a woman, gender norms, the nuclear family, and how those things have benefited through society and how they've been like the mainstream culture throughout most of history. And then finally, my last point was kind of the timing of LGBTQ plus rights right now. We have like the war in Ukraine going on, economic crisis, rising right-wing extremism, and kind of just all around the climate change, several problems that are emerging or getting worse. And is LGBTQ plus rights really the rights we want to be focusing on right now? Or are they safe to be focusing on? That was my presentation. Thank you.